Hey guys, David Kwan here. I want to talk here about the game Spec Ops The Line, which I played on my PS3. It's definitely a unique game as a whole, considering its storytelling and its moments and its scenes and all that. As a shooter though, it actually is just pretty much just a solid shooter. I mean, it goes through the motions of great mechanics, of amazing set pieces, of great graphics using descent, like the desert storm coming in, the sandstorm, and it's a really solid game mechanics-wise, but mechanics-wise, it really doesn't stand out, especially so if you're considering like the multiplayer component, which is so cookie-cutter. You know, it's just there to be there, and the shooting gameplay, it feels like it's just there to be there. There's really nothing super unique about the shooting thing. The level design is just kind of arena to arena, a corridor to corridor, so it's a pretty decent game to play, but I think all the buzz is really about like the story and all the crazy action scenes or the choices, or it feels like choices that you as a player make with the game. I think that's really the highlight of this game. What makes it unique for me, I think, is not really the storytelling itself, but the fact that this game is so driven to make you feel guilty. I think that was like the main objective with the game developers in this game. Like, they must have been thinking like, how do we write a game script where the player feels guilty at the end of the day? And they've done it. This is the game that will do that. I mean, for the most part, I can't think of any other game that does this. For majority of the game, the enemy is actually American soldiers. You're killing American soldiers in this game, whether they're like ex-CIA or CIA or ex-Special Forces or American soldiers gone rogue, I have no idea, but for majority of the game, that's who you're fighting against, rogue American soldiers. At the end of the game, you start to wonder, and this is kind of spoiler territory now, so if you don't want any spoilers or whatever, pretty much just stop watching this video right here, but yeah. At the end of the game, you start wondering, like, if you were the rogue American soldier in the first place. You know, it's that guilt-ridden. And I, you know, I don't know if I want to say I really enjoyed the experience, or if I, like, you know, but it's definitely something. It's unique in a shooter to make you question your own actions like that as it's going. You know, usually, this is a big premise in a lot of video games. In so many video games, it's just like, oh, I just realized I'm a bad guy now. There's so many of that. Shadow of the Colossus, Metal Gear Solid. So many games where it's just like you're betrayed. You realize at the end of the game, it's like, shit, I just fucked things up. Like, I'm the bad guy, actually. So, it's usually a plot twist. With Spec Ops The Line, I think the trick here is that it's not a plot twist. It's constant. Like, you constantly know you're not doing something that's right, but you're still moving forward. And the game actually does a really great job of making you not question why you're moving forward that much. Like, you gotta keep going, you wanna dig further into what's going on, and you still feel like you wanna help these people, but you know you're doing wrong, and even the game's loading screens will start justifying itself, and start, at the end of the game, even the game's loading screen actually blames you, like, you did this. You are the source of all the evil in this world right now. I thought that was amazing, the way they even incorporated loading screen into making you feel like shit. You know, like, this game really, no matter what choices you take, this game makes you feel like shit. Especially with the big climax, not the climax, but the biggest thing to happen in this game is obviously the white phosphorus scene. You know, I mean, that's my opinion. Feel free to, you know, disagree with me on that, but I think that was pretty much the scene that sets the tone where it's just like, holy shit, what did I do? And that's one of those scenes in the game where you don't have a control choice, because I replayed the game and there's no way to beat that section without using white phosphorus. So it's something that you have to do, but it makes sense in storytelling-wise. And then there's other parts in the game where you do kind of have a choice. You know, you have a choice of the guys hanging with the rope, you know, you have a choice to shoot. You have the choice to shoot which person to shoot. That was actually a pretty good moral test. And I didn't realize actually you can disobey that test and kind of die trying to disobey that test and stuff. So a lot of the moral tests scenes were, I think, were pretty awesome, just setup wise. Although playing them again, it doesn't really feel as heavy playing through again. Like, I think this is a game that was kind of meant to play once. I mean, why would you play again? I don't know why I would play again. The game already made me feel so shitty at myself. Why would I go through it again and make me feel more like shit? I don't know. But I think this game is the game to, like, make you feel as guilty as shit. That's the objective of this game, and for the most part, it succeeds. The only thing I kind of wish for the storytelling, I mean, there's the action sequences are actually pretty damn great. Like, falling off that gigantic building set piece, that was pretty awesome. I love the settings in this game, so colorful settings. I'm usually not the biggest fan of Unreal Engine 3 or Unreal Engine for that matter, but I thought it was really tastefully done in this game. It doesn't feel like just another Unreal Engine game to me, which was just pretty great, because I get a lot of that in a lot of games, like even Mass Effect. I got that syndrome. I'm like, great, Unreal Engine again. But yeah, definitely great use of the Unreal Engine, great set pieces. The only thing I kind of just have trouble going over is really the ending. It's kind of way too abrupt. I know they wanted to kind of just make you question, like, what happened or what's going on, but that was really just kind of bizarre. Because for the whole, for like, from like the first quarter of the game onwards, the game is just constantly making you question your actions, question what's going on. And then finally you reach that point, and then I'm just like, this is kind of what I've been reaching for. It's almost like too easy of an explanation at the end. And I don't know. I mean, ending, probably doing an ending to that game would have been a tough thing to do perfectly, as the game writers and makers, but I don't know, the ending left me a little left wanting, so to say. But definitely quite a game to, just, whew, it's quite a game. That's all I can say. I don't necessarily want to say if it's like a great game or, I mean, it's a fun game to shoot through, and the shooting mechanics are pretty solid. I like the all the mechanics, love the graphics, love the setting, but just like, it's a game that makes you feel like shit, so I don't know if that's like the game I would be recommending to anyone, you know?